Hey everyone, welcome aboard. At Plannerly, we are firm believers that BIM lies at the heart of every successful design and construction project. But let's face it, success doesn't just fall into our laps. Many of you in the industry have wrestled with BIM challenges and are currently navigating them. Maybe that's why you're here. Today, I'll dive into the hurdles I faced and the ones many of you in the industry have shared with us. I'll share some insights on how you can simplify and enhance your BIM execution planning workflow and show you how to organize your BIM tasks that come out of your BEP in a way to verify them against the model, all in just 5 simple steps. Let's get into it. Let's first talk about why we need BIM. As you know, BIM brings many benefits. It can help teams collaborate for coordination, sort field issues, help cost estimates, and have data-rich models for facilities management. It's used in many projects around the world, saving money during construction and making our work easier. However, to successfully implement BIM, we will need a BIM execution plan. It's essentially the construction document set for 3D models. It is used to communicate to every team handling the model of any processes, standards, and the overall expectations of the model. Your BEP must be very clear and have clear workflow to execute successfully. If it's not, we will end up with unusable models, or in this case, a model that's just too small. As some of you may already know, there are many challenges that come with the creation and management of a BEP. Some teams usually say they just take way too long to create, gather feedback from all team members, and make those updates. Usually, they end up getting created by one person or copied from previous projects that have information that doesn't make sense. For those that make it past the creating part, you might find no one reading them. And then there's a checking workflow. Because it's a text or a spreadsheet, it's difficult to check it against the 3D model. Today, I'll cover 5 steps that will help you and your team successfully implement and overcome these challenges. I'll show a few tips to create and agree on your BEP, show how to create and gain approval on a clear BIM scope, sequence your BIM tasks to make sure they're received on time, show how to manage your BIM tasks as a team, and finally, I'll cover how to verify your BIM requirements against the model. Let's get to step 1, how to create and agree on your BEP. The first thing we need to agree on are the expectations of a model. These are known as our BIM uses. Will the model be used for clash or 3D coordination, cost estimates, or even asset handover? These are just some uses of a 3D model. Make sure you're in agreement with everyone handling or using the model, whether it's the client, consultants, subcontractors, or even internal team members. Make sure no one is left out because we all need to be on the same page. Once you have agreement on the BIM use, between you and your team, ask, what are the processes for each use? Are there any standards required? What are the deliverable file types required? Is there specific technology like hardware or software we need to use? Be clear with the information, create process maps, or use images to describe the workflow. We will talk about things like LOD, information requirements, or level of information need later when we define our scope. Collaboration is key for successful implementation. Teams that contribute effort or are asked for feedback are more likely to follow through. If you can, share responsibilities across the team by assigning sections. Clearly indicate which sections are open for updates or comments. Communicate the one method for feedback so that you can keep track efficiently and in one place. Finally, communicate which parts of the documents are approved for use. A common excuse for not implementing is the lack of access to the document or receiving the latest updates. Ensure everyone is on the same page by providing immediate access to the latest version in a common data environment, or CDE. We recommend to regularly archive the documents as updates are made or as sections are approved. So in order to ensure a successful BIM execution plan implementation, define your requirements, standards, and processes clearly. Seek feedback from everyone involved. Establish a transparent communication channel for feedback and ensure easy accessibility to your BEP. Now that we've established a BEP workflow, our next step is to outline a scope that clearly communicates who is modeling what. Each team has their own take on what the model should look like. An architect will focus more on the design, look, and drawing set, while the contractors and subs may care more about the data that can be extracted. Creating a scope will clearly communicate to all disciplines on who is modeling what, at what level, or LOD, and when. Your scope is key to managing everyone's priorities, and to do this, we tend to create spreadsheets to outline all of this information. However, as some have experienced, a spreadsheet that needs to describe responsibility, LOD, geometry, level of information need, and much more will easily end up this very complex, intimidating document, especially to those who did not create it. Let's look at the information we need to describe in our scope and how to make it clear. We can start by asking a few questions. Why are we doing BIM? What are our BIM uses? How much information and LOD or geometry is needed for that BIM use? Who is responsible for what? And when and where do we start? We don't need all this information at once, but we do need a clear way to put it all into one place. Display the milestones deliverables clearly. These are typically your BIM uses. Create a list of content that will be needed. It's easier to list the content if you concentrate one BIM use at a time. Be sure to assign or display each element to the required milestone. Remember, not every element is needed for every milestone, so let's not create more work than we need to. Agree with your team on the necessary LOD or geometry requirements for each task. Each use might have a separate LOD requirement. See if there are any information requirements. These are like parameters and values required in the model to be pulled from the elements later on. The best way is to find out who will be using the model and get a clear list of requirements. If a list doesn't already exist, build one together. And the most obvious is who is responsible for each task. Make it crystal clear when they are due and if there are any element or model handovers. Once you have a scope established, put it through an approval workflow. Make sure every team is in agreement on what they will either receive or be required to deliver. Now that we have a scope agreement, it's time to define when and where to start with the schedule. Creating a timeline is crucial as it allows teams to plan and manage team members' workload. It also prevents you from being bombarded by a ton of tasks right at the deadline. Schedules also come with their challenges, though. Sometimes rather than working together on a shared timeline, teams tend to follow their own individual schedules, resulting in out-of-sequence work and adding a bunch of rework. This ultimately causes many missed deadlines and lots of overtime. Your schedule is a crucial piece between your scope, requirements, and successfully delivering tasks on time. Managing your tasks in small bits can be much easier to manage. Consider a schedule for each milestone. Having a schedule that shows what needs to come first helps teams prioritize their work and understand how project changes affect the overall project. Be sure to display dependencies between tasks and team members responsible. Remember, we all have our priorities and tasks to juggle, but if we can have all teams work in sync, we will implement BIM successfully. The schedule is basically the kickoff for modeling teams. As teams begin to start their tasks, it's crucial to have a way to stay on top of them to ensure deadlines are met. Usually, we use progress reports to stay on top of our tasks. But we've experienced that BIM managers spend a ton of time making these reports, which takes away from the important tasks they're supposed to be focused on. Similar to a schedule, each team might have their own to-do list. It's then up to one person or the BIM manager to collect updates from team members and create report for upper management. This leads to questionable updates or reports. For clear and concise updates, consider a Kanban board. There are many task management tools out there, but the most effective are collaborative Kanban boards that allow each team member to make updates on their own. Be sure that the tasks that you're tracking directly relate to the BIM task from your scope. Use classification codes or naming conventions to name each task. Organize your Kanban board in a way that makes sense for the project workflow. For teams managing team workload, consider organized by team member. For teams wanting to see the overall team progress, organize tasks by team. And for clear understanding of milestone progress, view your tasks by status. Giving your team members the ability to advance their own tasks increases the chances of success. It also becomes less work on you or the BIM manager to gather task updates from everyone to update progress. Integrating your task data with the dashboard grants managers and team members to access and view status at any time. An integrated dashboard allows teams to compare progress between projects and manage workloads. It also helps project managers or BIM managers see project progress by team. Integrations usually require some technical expertise, but if you can, just keep it simple. Dashboards can help save us time from having to create progress reports. However, they are sometimes still required. If you do, archive by milestone to track project progress over time, or export task reports for individual team and team members to keep the team focused on key tasks. And archive on a regular basis, either when updates are made or on a reoccurring schedule. The final and maybe the most important step of the workflow is to have a clear and simple compliance check. Delivering and using models that are not in compliance to the BEP can be disastrous. For example, clash coordination hinges on having every element properly modeled and on time. We can't model MEP services without structural content, so things need to be modeled correctly and on time. Verifying a 3D model against the text document has been one of the biggest challenges. The requirements are usually in multiple locations or scattered in complex documents. Teams have usually had to be creative or implement manual methods to verify models. To start your checking on the right foot, make sure to gather all the necessary information for the tasks in one place. It's a time saver, preventing you from hunting around for reference data. Keep your LOD, geometry, and information requirements organized in one place. And don't forget to include any links or attachments to resources that will help you and your team understand what's needed for that element. To save time during checking, have a clear list of what to check for. It's not just about listing all the content from that deliverable. It's about setting up your Kanban flow for team members to flag you or notify you as tasks are ready. Avoid wasting time on unready tasks. Communicate fixes and update the task accordingly. Go through this cycle until all tasks are completed. Once you've finished all the tasks in your BEP for each milestone, share that model in your CDE and let the team know it's been reviewed and verified for use. Remember, the purpose of a BEP is to make sure models have the necessary information for their use. So don't use an unverified or an unpublished model. So to recap, remember to gain agreement by all parties on your BEP. Create a clear scope that everyone can understand. Schedule and sequence your tasks to work efficiently. Track progress of tasks to make sure nothing is missed. And verify all model deliverables against the original requirements. As you've seen, a BIM execution plan is more than just a document. It's a dynamic workflow that ensures all requirements are met. We at Plannerly are here for you. If you need any assistance, you can reach out to us directly or through the in-app chat on the bottom right-hand corner.